folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on watching buckets and other things on MinIO using the Go language. And in this video, we're going to be using Go 1.19. We're going to be watching play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be running all of this out of VS Code. And by the end of this video, you will know how to use the listen bucket notification function as well as the listen notification function, and we'll show you some of the differences between the two. Let's go ahead and take a look at some code. So here we are in the main package with our main function. I've done a few imports here, context, format, log, common Go packages, and then I also imported my MinIO demo functions package so that I can stand up this connection to MinIO. And it's going to connect out to play.min.io for us and give us back a MinIO client that we can work with. So let's take a look at our main function. I've set up three string variables, the bucket name, a prefix name, and also a suffix name. So when I set up this listen bucket notification, it takes a bucket name, and then the rest of this is me limiting what I want to see events on. First, I'm limiting it to the prefix backup. I'm limiting it to a suffix of .txt. So I'm only going to look at text files that are uploaded to my backup prefix inside of that Go demo bucket. And then I have an array of strings. And these strings are limiting the S3 type events that I'm going to be looking for. In this case, I'm looking for created, accessed, and removed on objects. Now, what this returns to me is a notification info channel. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to read out of this notification info channel. The channel will remain open until an error occurs. And then I'm just going to print out the notification info every time I see one. So let's take a look at how this code is going to work. I very simply am just going to do a go run dot, and it's going to sit here for a moment. And all it's doing now is it's opened that channel and it's looking for items to be uploaded, to be created or accessed or removed in the Go demo bucket under the backup prefix with a suffix of .txt. So let me go ahead and run something up there. I have another terminal window here running. This is going to allow me to do the MC command. I'm going to copy my HW text, and I'm going to copy that up to play.min.io into the Go demo bucket. Now, I'm going to run this. It uploads just fine. If I go back to my Go terminal, no event. Let me go ahead and run this one more time with the backup prefix. And when I run it with the backup prefix, there we go. Now I'm actually seeing something run here. Now, I've got a lot of accesses here. I've got a put, and then I've got some accesses here as well. And basically what's happening here is that I've got versioning turned on. So there's a bunch of extra noise that's happening because I'm creating all these different versions as I upload that particular HW text. And you'll notice here, the last one that came in right here, 2012, 13, 15, 15, 43. That's the last one that came in. We're going to go ahead and I'm going to run one more, and I'm going to upload im.png again to the backup prefix. And when I upload that, notice there is no change to my listing. This is because I haven't uploaded another text file. So that is everything that I want to show you there about listen bucket notification, but let's go a little bit wider. I don't have to limit it to just a bucket. We have a second function, the listen notification function. Now, the listen notification function does not require a bucket name. What this is going to do is it's going to be limited to my prefix name and my suffix name that I've got here. And again, I'm limiting it to the same object created, object accessed, object removed. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. And if I do a go run, it's going to sit there again. And if I upload impng, nothing. But if I upload instead the HW text, now I'm getting all my output again. So not limited to the bucket, I'm still limiting it to a prefix name and a suffix name. Let me go ahead and widen this even further. I'm going to give it no prefix, no suffix. I'm actually going to add a couple more items to this list. I'm going to add bucket created and bucket removed. So now I can actually watch to see if any buckets are created or deleted as well. And I'm going to go ahead and save this. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this. Now, as you might imagine, I am now not limiting anything, which means that practically any creation or deletion activity that takes place on play.min.io will register with this. So let me go ahead and run this again. Go run. And we're just going to let this sit for a moment and get some feedback. Okay, there we go. Somebody has created a bucket out there on play.min.io. They called it test my bucket, bunch of zeros. Interesting. The source IP address is weird. That's odd. 127.0.0.1. That's localhost. Okay. Anyway. So now I'm basically watching all of play.min.io and anything that happens up there that involves creation, removal, anything, objects that are created or removed, will be triggering an event that I can now watch. Now, of course, if I want to quit this, I just control C. If I wanted to do something else with these notifications, of course, I could use it to trigger some other piece of work in my Go environment, in my Go program. But this is a very simple way to use listen notification, listen bucket notification, to actually see events happening in real time on your MinIO platform. Now, things of note, I didn't set up any kind of events happening on the bucket side. This is literally just me setting up a listener on my side. I have, of course, credentials that allow me to see everything, which of course is one of the reasons why you want to make sure you have good credentials, because if you're using the root credential like I am, then everybody can see anything. But that is just a few of the different ways that you can set up a listener to watch for events on MinIO. I hope you've enjoyed this little how-to on watching events on MinIO. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can chat with us interactively on slack.min.io, or you can just give us a reply here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.